This is the Cal 101 podcast on Cape Atlantic Live. Here's your host, Nick Kosko.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Cal 101 podcast on Cape Atlantic Live. I'm your host, Nick Kosko, and today we have a special guest ahead of the Cal basketball semifinals of the Cape Atlantic League tournament, of course, coming up in the middle of this weekend. Pleased to be joined now by the press of AC's Mike McGarry. Mike, thanks for joining me, man. And I gotta say, this is pretty much a chalk tournament on the boys' side. Little surprises on the girls' side, but otherwise, looks like we have the best four on the boys' and girls' side when it comes to the Cape Atlantic League tournament this year.
Yeah, you have to say the seeding committee did a good job, right? Top four seeds get through on the boys' side, and what, three of the top four get through on the girls' side with Holy Spirit as the number six seed. So Holy Spirit girls being in there, the lone exception. So great job by the seeding committee.
Yeah, no doubt. So let's start with the boys' side. And, of course, the number one team right now, Middle Township. They just pretty much rolled through the bracket so far. They're coming off a 53-37 win over St. Augustine Prep in the quarterfinals. They'll take on Atlantic City, the fourth seed. And, obviously, we know the whole deal with Atlantic City. They were reinstated into the Cape Atlantic League tournament. They won't be playing in the state playoffs, but this is a good opportunity for them to perhaps pull a bit of an upset right here and go out with a title at Egg Harbor Township, the host site this weekend as well. What do you make of Middle Township in Atlantic City in this quarterfinal game?
Yeah, I think it'll be a good game, right? They played back on Martin Luther King Day with down at Middle Township with Middle winning 54-48. Like you said, for Atlantic City, this is their postseason. There is no state tournament to come down the road for them. They were disqualified from the tournament because of that incident that happened at Mainland in early January. So should be an interesting game. It's an interesting matchup. You know what? Middle does well. Atlantic City also does well. Middle has a lot of athletic players. Guard Jameer McNeil, maybe one of the better all-around players in the Cape Atlantic League. Anthony Trombetta, good three-point shooter. Rial Basqueen inside, you know, is a force inside. And Atlantic City really relies on its junior guards, Peaky Roseborough and Chris Finks, who has been playing especially well lately. So, you know, six-point game the first time they played down in Middle. We'll see what happens Wednesday night in Millville.
Yeah, and you have Atlantic City coming off a 75-70 win over Hamilton to get to this point. They also defeated Pleasantville in their first game as the fourth seed. That was 70-37. That was last week in the first round after the play-in games. And if you go to the other side of the bracket, of course, Ocean City and Mainland. I know everybody's looking forward to this one. They had a pretty competitive game at Mainland a couple of weeks ago, won by Ocean City. So they do get the tiebreak inevitably over the Mustangs, that two seeds. Interesting, though, for the an aside, in the South Jersey Group 3 playoffs, looks like Mainland is projected to get the number one seed while Ocean City will get the two based on the power points. But they are flip-flopped here, but inevitably they will face off in the semifinals here in the Cape Atlantic League tournament. Mike, what do you make of this classic rivalry being renewed once again?
Yeah, rivals in every sport, right? Ocean City, Mainland, the definition of neighborhood rivals, you know, a bay separates the two schools. Ocean City won 59-52 at Mainland on January 29th. Corey Segic averaging about 25 points a game. He's been the leading scorer in the Cape Atlantic League, an outstanding season for him. The thing about Ocean City is they only play five guys, right? They usually, you know, if they get a sixth guy in there, it's only for a minute or so. So the five starters really, really have to be on top of their game. A guy who's playing especially well for Ocean City the past couple of weeks is Charlie Labari. He's kind of picked up his game. And because of that, Ocean City's been able to go to another level. They're 22-2. It's the best regular season in Coach John Bruno's career, who's been the Ocean City coach for about 30 years. So really a memorable season for Ocean City. And on the flip side, you got a Mainland team that, you know, started out the year great, kind of hit a swoon in the middle of the season, right? They lost to Atlantic City. They lost to Eastern. They lost to Paul the Sixth. Well, in the last four or five games, Mainland looks like they're back on track. They beat CBA, a good CBA team of Monmouth County, by 30 points. They beat Atlantic City by about 20, and they beat Lower Cape May in the quarterfinals. We all know the Mainland names, Cohen Cook, Tim Traveline, Jamie Tyson. This group won the CAL as sophomores. You know, whenever Mainland Ocean City play, you can never go wrong going to that game and see them play in a semifinal, 5 o'clock Wednesday at Millville. You know, that's a big time game.
Mainland coming off the 66-51 win over Lower Cape May. As you alluded to, Ocean City beat Absogami 59-52 in the quarterfinals. We look at these two games, though, Mike, as far as the winners are concerned, I believe a lot of people would have, you know, Middle Township. They seem like they were the best team on paper when it came to the preseason expectations, and they've proven that pretty much all year long with the number one seed, and they're projected to be number one in South Group 2 as well. As far as what you see on the boys' side here, how do you see these games unfolding? It seems like Middle might have the edge over Atlantic City, but then Mainland Ocean City can basically go the other in either direction. But then again, you know, it is high school basketball. It almost seems like you can't count out Atlantic City as well due to the nature of the way they play, very physical, and they really basically can make the game a pretty much congested, and it can force you into a lot of mistakes.
Yeah, I mean, Middle Township 23-2. I think you'd have to say that they're the favorite to win the tournament going into this event. They haven't played Mainland yet this season, but they've beaten Ocean City twice. They've beaten Atlantic City, and they're undefeated in the Cape Atlantic League, right? So you have to give them the edge. Plus, there's a lot of big game experience on the Middle Township team. This group won the South Jersey Group 2 championship last year. This group went to the state group semifinals last year. So it's a big-time team with big-time experience. You can't sell Atlantic City short, however, with the way they're playing and the fact that, you know, this is it for Atlantic City. This is their Super Bowl on Wednesday night and this week if they would get to the final on Saturday. There is no state tournament to come for Atlantic City, so this is their Super Bowl. You know, a key to the game is just going to be, can Atlantic City score with Middle Township? Middle Township, it sounds simple, right? The team with the most points wins the game, obviously. You're probably like, great insight, Mike, but Middle Township's got a lot of firepower. They can get scoring from Jameer McNeil. They can get scoring from Bubba McNeil, his older brother. They can get Anthony Trombetta. Zarfati can hit threes. Basqueen can go inside. They can bring Elston and Aiden Howell off the bench to get points. Can Atlantic City match that? You know, that firepower, you know, can Atlantic City get scoring from beyond Roseborough and thinks, can a guy like Mikel Jones, who hit, I think, 5 3-pointers against Hamilton, can he step forward? Can they get it from another guy? That's going to be the key to that game. Mainland Ocean City, again, it was 59-52 the first time they played each other. You know, we'll see what happens in this game. Again, Mainland playing well and Ocean City playing well. And like you said, they couldn't meet again in the South Jersey Group 3 tournament. So that's a game where really, you know, anything can happen there. That's a kind of make or miss game. The team that makes the most shots, makes that timely perimeter three, late third quarter, early fourth quarter. The team that gets that run, late third quarter, early fourth quarter, that's going to be the difference in that game.
Yeah, that'll surely be the difference, as you mentioned. Again, looking forward to those exciting games on Wednesday at Millville, but we'll flip our attention over to the girls' side of things. And again, the top four seeds and the boys have made it to the semifinals, and that was almost the same thing for the girls' end of things. Number one, Mainland, is going to be taking on number four, Middle Township. So similar teams, you know, a lot of doubleheaders, it seems like, for these schools as well. And on the flip side, Wildwood Catholic, the number two seed, will be taking on Holy Spirit, the sixth seed, who pulled off an upset of Ulmer. Before we get there, though, Mike, Mainland, Middle Township, Mainland's been the favorite all season long. Again, when you look at that, those preseason rankings that you guys put out on the Press of Atlantic City, it seemed like the Mustangs were the team to beat in the Cape Atlantic League again. Of course, you know, maybe to win a South Jersey title as well here in 2024. Middle's been very good as well. They were really good last year. Your quick breakdown of this one right here between Mainland and Middle, and who's going to possibly advance here to the Cape Atlantic League finals.
Yeah, Mainland, the number one seed, ranked number one in our Elite 11. I think they're 23-1. The only loss is to State Power, St. John Vianney. They are the defending Cape Atlantic League champion. They are a veteran group. It seems like these kids have been in high school for 10 years, right? Casey Pertonis, the twins, Ava and Bella Mazer, and Sydney Stokes, the center. So really just a veteran Mainland group. And what sets them apart, I think, this season from last season is Pertonis is a much more consistent offensive player than she was last year. She's averaging 17 points a game. She's already one of the best defensive players in the state, but now she's added a more consistent part to her offensive game. She's a Division I player, obviously, going to the University of Massachusetts. Mainland is just tough to beat. They've already beaten Middle Township twice. You got a Middle Township team. Give them all the credit in the world for getting here, right? They're the number four seed. They won seven in a row. Their best player, senior forward Madison Palak, broke her foot back in January on that Martin Luther King Day playing against Bishop Eustis. We talked about Middle boys beating Atlantic City boys that day. Well, in the game before that, Madison Palak breaks her foot. She's out for the season. Real tough story for her. Second straight year, she's broke the foot. Second straight year, her season has been curtailed because of it. She's Middle's best player. Middle somehow survives. Her sister, Mackenzie Palick, steps up. Hannah Capoletti steps up. Sophomore Reagan Powell steps up. And somehow Middle Township overcomes the loss of Madison, plays team basketball, and finds itself in the Cape Atlantic League semifinals again. So Mainland's the dominant team, but you can't undersell what Middle has done to get here.
No, a lot of grit and fight from Middle Township for sure. Their path to the semifinals, beating Atlantic City 53-39 in the first round, and they took out a pretty good Egg Harbor Township squad 45-28. But Mainland's been obviously dominant, 76-22 over Bridgeton, then 66-52 over Absagami in the last two games. On the flip side, though, Mike, it's Wildwood Catholic, the number two seed. As you mentioned before, the seeding committee, they did quite a good job for the Cape Atlantic League this year on both sides. It's been pretty much all chalk, but Holy Spirit's been on a bit of a run right here, knocking off Millville, and they upset Ulmer 62-56 last Friday. What do you make about this run with Holy Spirit right now? I know Wildwood Catholic probably has the edge in this game to meet number one Mainland in the finals, but Holy Spirit's got a little something cooking, it seems like.
Yeah, Holy Spirit, right? They play in that American division where their only losses are really to Mainland, Wildwood Catholic, and Middle Township. Sabrina Little, a junior guard, played a great game the other night against Ulmer. She's had a great season so far. She sparked the Holy Spirit team great. And Riley Burns, a sophomore, has been, you know, a consistent outside shooter. I think she has more than 43 pointers. So, and of course, Coach Tim Whitworth, you know, if you want to play basketball, you want to play for a guy like Tim Whitworth. He plays a lot of people. He gets a lot of girls in the game. They play at a fast pace, up tempo, fun way to play. So that's what Holy Spirit has going for them. On the other side, you got Wildwood Catholic, 21-2. The only losses are to Mainland. Wildwood Catholic ranked number two in our Elite 11. And just like Mainland, it seems like they've got kids who have been in high school forever. Casey Mikulski, Elliot McCabe, Ava Voges, Destiny Wallace. Seems like they've been in forever. And then you add in the freshman, Lola McGonigal, who's averaging 13, 14 points a game. You got a really, really good Wildwood Catholic team there. So this, even though Wildwood Catholic has beaten Spirit twice already, Spirit's playing well. They've got momentum coming off the Ulmer win. So we'll see what happens, 5 p.m. Tuesday in Atlantic City.
Yeah, it seems like momentum can carry you through a basketball tournament. We see it all the time at the college level and NCAA March Madness. And that's basically what basketball is all about. You get hot, and you can really make a deep run. So the girls will play Tuesday at Atlantic City at 5-7, boys 5-7 at Millville on Wednesday. A couple more for you, Mike, just to look at these games once more, just to kind of wrap it up. Looking ahead to the finals at Egg Harbor Township at 12 o'clock and 2 o'clock on Saturday. That they are the host school once again for the Cape Atlantic League finals. What do you see as far as results on Tuesday and Wednesday? Who's going to be meeting up? I mean, do we get middle against Mainland, Middle against Ocean City, Atlantic City into the boys' final? I mean, do we see both Mainland squads? I mean, how do you see these games unfolding on the boys' and girls' side, and who are we going to see with those four squads on Saturday?
Yeah, you never know, right? But if you look at it, I think the top seeds are going to be tough to sort of upset in the semifinals. So I think Middle Township is going to be tough to beat. But again, you can't sell Atlantic City short because of, again, how well they're playing and what they're playing for. Again, this is their Super Bowl. There is no state tournament. The Mainland girls are the defending champions. They beat Middle twice. We give Middle all the... we tip our cap to the Middle Township girls for what they've overcome to get here. Do they have enough scoring to beat Mainland on Tuesday? I think it's a tough order, but you can't sell a John Leahy team short. So I think, the top seeds, Middle boys and Mainland girls probably get through. The other two games, you got a Holy Spirit team up against Wildwood Catholic. Wildwood Catholic has a lot of scoring there. We'll see what the Spartans can do. Wildwood Catholic beat Spirit by double digits twice. We'll see if Spirit can make that up. And on the other flip side of the game, again, that's just going to come down to Ocean City Mainland, who makes shots at the right time. So I think, with all due respect to my friends on all four teams, you put me on the spot here, but I won't shy away. I think you're going to see a Wildwood Catholic Mainland game on Saturday and the girls. And as far as the boys go, boy, You know, I'm not going to pick between Ocean City and Mainland, but I think whoever wins that game, Middle Township will be waiting there for them. But, you know, for any team to get to the Cape Atlantic League semifinals is just a great achievement overall.
Yeah, it's a deep tournament. Obviously, all the teams make it. When you look down the line, you have to go through the play-in games, first-round quarters and semis, and even just to get to that final stage. But we always love a good Mike McGarry hot take, especially when it's not on Twitter. He can explain himself a little bit more and not get too much backlash on social media because we know how that goes all the time.
There you go. All my Philadelphia Eagles fans, friends. There you go.
Yeah. Oh, I know. I won't roast you too bad for your Eagle takes on Twitter, obviously. Mike McGarry, the Press of Atlantic, stay with me here on Cal 101, presented by Ulmer's Appliance Service on Cape Atlantic Live. Mike, appreciate the time as always. We'll see you out there for the semis and, of course, for the finals at Egg Harbor Township on Saturday.
Yeah, and it's I would urge all high school basketball fans in the area to get out to these games. Tuesday, Atlantic City. Wednesday, Millville. Saturday at Egg Harbor Township. There's no more football. Football's over. March Madness is still a couple of weeks away. These are great games, great entertaining games. I'd urge everybody to go out and take in, you know, some local high school basketball this week. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Absolutely. We'll have coverage on Cape Atlantic Live as always as well. I'm Nick Kosko, signing off once again for the Cal 101 podcast presented by Ulmer's Appliance Service right here on Cape Atlantic Live.